Attention please. Yes. From yesterday we start vitamin. Had we finished vitamin A? Okay. Today we are going to talk about vitamin D. As you know, vitamin D we can get directly from sunlight, mostly in the morning. So let's start from the deficiency of the vitamin D. There are two types of the deficiencies in vitamin D. First is nutritional rickets. And second one is the osteomalacia, not mellitus, malacia. Sometimes the deficiency of vitamin D can cause renal rickets. So this is the deficiency of the vitamin D. So what is the physiological role of vitamin D? So vitamin D is improve our absorption of calcium and phosphorus. It is essential in the formation of bone and tooth. Vitamin D also maintains our system. So I will mention all our deficiency, all our physiological role about vitamin D. So some generic name of vitamin D like calciferol. Second one is cholecalciferol. Third one is calcitriol. Here calciferol is D2, cholecalciferol is D3 and calcitriol is active vitamin. So listen carefully, here dosage of calciferol is 5 microgram, dosage of D3 is 200 international unit, means calciferol, and dosage of calcitriol is very less, 1 microgram. So this is the generic name and dosage of vitamin D.
So now we are going to talk about adverse effect or excesses of vitamin D. Adverse effect and excessive of vitamin D. He will feel like the adverse effect is itching, dryness, burning irritation, and erythema. Okay. The toxicity of vitamin D is poor appetite. Okay. Second one is nausea, vomiting, frequent urination, these all are symptoms of hypercalcemia. So the toxicity of vitamin D can cause hypercalcemia. So what is the symptom of the hypercalcemia? Nausea, vomiting, frequent urination, and poor appetite. Now we are going to talk about vitamin K. Vitamin K. So what is the physiological role of vitamin K? It will be prevent our internal bleeding. In female, it will be reduce heavy menstrual cycle or menstrual flow.
So here is some generic name of vitamin K, and that's our first one is phytonadione, second is menaquinone or naphthoquinone, and third is menadione. So doses of phytonadione, menaquinone, and menadione is, so phytonadione we can use 50 to 100 microgram, menaquinones we can use 50 microgram, and menadione we can use also 50 microgram.
Now we are going to talk about what is the deficiency of the vitamin K. Head disease. Vitamin K can cause weakness in bone, so that's called weakened bone. Okay. Vitamin K can also can do decay of tooth. Okay. A warning sign of vitamin K deficiency is bleeding and bruising easily, like from gums or nose. So Vitamin K can cause
gingivitis, gums bleeding, and epistaxis, nose bleeding.
What will happen when somebody take vitamin K in excessive? So, excessive of vitamin K. Excessive of vitamin K can cause like general symptom nausea, abdomen cramps, diarrhea, headache, chronic symptoms like liver cirrhosis and hepatosplenomegaly. Vitamin K is important for our nervous system. So I will mention some neurological disorder when somebody take vitamin K in excessive. So like ataxia, papilledema, and diplopia. Do you know about what is ataxia, what is papilledema, and what is the diplopia? So ataxia is lack of voluntary coordination of muscles movement. Okay, papilledema, this is very important of neurological disorder.
When we took vitamin K in excess, then in CNS the pressure will be increased and optic nerve will be disturbed. Okay, and eyeball will be swollen. Okay, so in papilledema, eyeball will swollen. Okay, so this is the papilledema. Yes, please. Diplopia is, so di means double and plopia means vision. So patient will be see double. So now we are going to talk about vitamin E. Okay,
so what is the physiological role of vitamin E? So physiological role of vitamin E is very important for blood.
It will be help in supplying oxygen to the blood. Supplying oxygen to the blood. Okay. Second one is vitamin E prevent blood clot. It will be slow cellular aging.
Support in slow cellular aging.
So vitamin A will be help in the aging also. There are some generic name of the vitamin E. So generic name of vitamin A, that one is alpha tocopherol. So alpha tocopherol we can use in 10 milligram. Okay, so deficiency of the vitamin E. As we know, vitamin E supplying oxygen to the blood. So some degeneration changes in CNS, central nervous system, spinal cord, mainly skeletal muscle and heart, because of
oxygen will be reduced in the blood.
Hemolytic anemia, also the deficiency of vitamin A. Excessive of vitamin A is abdominal cramp, loose motion. Loose motion is the very important. Okay, and nausea, vomiting, headache is generally. Okay, one more important of excessive of vitamin E is increased risk of prostate cancer and blurred vision. Okay, so this is the fat soluble vitamin general discussion.